Hey guys, welcome back to The Guard Prevails. This is episode 3. I'm Arthur Perkins, this is AP Gaming Reel, etc, etc. Let's talk some real talk right now. Pokemon Moon came out today, and they suddenly revealed that your Pokemon bank will not be accessible until January 20th or something. It's insane. I spent all this time making all these level 1 Pokemon of the highest breed. Their pedigree took me like 40 hours to create these things during my vacation. I just an entire team of monsters waiting to be unleashed upon the Pokemon world. And now I don't have them, and I'm very sad. But my plan is, on that January 20th, I'm going to level them up really fast, and then I'm going to play competitive and show them the power of a fully operational Eevee team. Just a whole team full of Eevees. It's been a bizarre day, and weird things are happening everywhere. And apparently people are having pre-Black Friday, Black Friday sales today. And Black Friday sales are opening at 7 o'clock local time in most stores on Thanksgiving.
Isn't it Friday right now?
Wow.
No?
Yes, it is Friday.
This is the pre-Black Friday Friday where they're also having Black Friday sales.
So we actually have made it back an entire week now?
No. Yeah. I mean, and yes, technically, yes.
And it's extended out because there's Cyber Monday now, too.
I mean, there's been Cyber Monday for a decade.
It's a behemoth. Yeah.
So
it's not Cyber Monday is nothing new.
The good news.
Folks, don't trample yourself.
Let's just hope the growth rate isn't exponential.
Yes, that's true. Otherwise, we're going to be starting Christmas at Thanksgiving dinner.
Yeah.
So, other than that, I have been watching a lot of pirate-related stuff. I'm ending 2 tabletop RPG campaigns this week, and then launching 2 more in an unknown time. I have the Patreon meeting on Sunday night, and I'm going to have to go to my Patreons and be like, hey, sorry, since the last time we talked, everything exploded. Here's a new bunch of shows. Really hope you love them.
I'm sure they will.
Listen, board meetings are hard. So, Fraser, let's start with you. I got this really cool email this week that was like, hey man, the Veil is launching finally. Why don't you sign your name to this book so we can put you in the PDF? And I was like, it's here. It's finally here. This is my moment. Because I happen to know that my name starts with an A, and that's the front of the alphabet, which means it's really likely I'm going to be right there in like the top 5 of names.
You're right at the top of my YouTube subscriber lists.
It's true. It's true.
Yeah, there is benefits to being first in the alphabet.
I know. I mean, are A names superior? Are A names superior? Yes. Yes, they are. But we can't all choose to be born like this. We just need parents who recognize that A names are better.
Yep. Yeah. The
come on, I Sam. Just, come on, work with me here. No.
I'll be happy with my middle name, as that does start with an A.
I'm pretty close. F is all right.
F is okay. It's okay.
Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna keep to the back of the alphabet. You
know?
I guess like the middle is where I'm at. Like,
it could be worse. It could start with like a V or something, right?
As Virgil just gives you the death stare right through the camera.
Yeah.
I was actually distracted by something behind the camera, so it's probably even creepier.
Your cat, more cats, just cats everywhere.
Yeah, my cat is just playing at my feet.
Listen, I didn't know anything about the starter Pokemon, by the way, just to jump back to Pokemon. Apparently, it's an owl with a bow tie, a dumb-looking seal, and a black cat that breathes fire. And so I think it's obvious which one I picked.
I named it
after my cat. Yeah. They're very much alike. They tend to knock things over, hit things with their claws, and breathe fire on random creatures. Fraser, how are you doing this week?
I'm great. I got actually just this morning, the layout guy sent me the almost finished PDF with all the artwork and everything looks great. So I'm expecting, I don't know, maybe max like another week to send it out to the backers because I got to proof it again. But other than that, it looks like it's perfect. So I'm excited. And I'm launching my other game in like a day or two, Young at Heart too, with the comic strip AP that comes out for the Gauntlet one of the days, either Saturday or Sunday or something like that. So just watch for it because I don't know exactly when.
Okay. Perfect.
We did a playthrough of the Veil, just to remind everybody, not kid friendly at all. Ooh. Not even close. But if you're willing to jump into that PG-13 plus category, you can join us on the Veil for Cyber Iceland's Hive form.
Well, I was pretty much muted the whole time because I was laughing.
I know. We destroyed your game around you. You were like, this is a very serious game about very serious concepts. And we were like, nope, suntan lotion. It's a game about suntan lotion as a form of currency.
Yeah, everything was about vitamin D.
Yep. Okay, so continuing clockwise. Kelsa, how are you doing this week?
Hello. I'm doing fairly well. I'm doing fairly well this week. I don't have anything super exciting coming up that I'm going to talk about right now. I might have more things to talk about soon. So the only change to my gaming schedule is moving from being a game master of Blades in the Dark to being a player in Burning Wheel. And I'm excited for that because I know at least a couple people at this table play Burning Wheel.
True.
And so I've been really looking forward to getting back and playing Burning Wheel. So I'm kind of excited about that.
I mean, we're basically playing Burning Wheel right now. We're playing Burning Wheel Light.
Yeah, we are. It's true. But I want to get into that heavy stuff.
Or I guess you could say we're playing Burning Wheel Chibi because we're little.
Yeah. I was going to suggest decaf because...
Ooh, yeah, I like that.
Decaf coffee kind of tastes just as good.
Burning decaf. I mean, that's true. It still tastes equally bad. That's right, coffee lovers. I hate the thing that you love.
No.
I know. It's how I strike
you
down.
My world is falling.
It's true. I mean, there's stuff we can't talk about right now, Kelsa. Like the secret thing that we're planning that we can't talk about.
A secret thing.
I mean, no, our secret Christmas show isn't secret. We told everybody we were going to do that.
We told them it was a secret, though.
No, we didn't. I was literally like, we're going to do a Star Wars reunion show probably at Christmas. And we said it like 15 times in the last episode.
Why is it still labeled as secret? I mean,
the channel is secret, so other people can't read it.
Well, that's exclusive.
Yeah, I could call it exclusive secret channel. Listen, I have a ton of secret channels in my Discord.
All the secret.
You have a lot of channels, period.
I have a lot of. Don't worry, we're gonna be wiping them in like a week. They'll be gone. It'll be like mass hysteria as the world slowly deletes itself. All right. I can't listen. If we keep going like this, I'm gonna start talking about Pokemon again. Wizenedfool, Sam, how are you doing this week?
I am good. I am very good. It's good to be playing. I am a little bit sad that I'm not gonna be able to play on Sunday for Burning Crowns, which everyone should tune into. But I am very excited to start an orc campaign of Burning Wheel that I will be running tomorrow. So
you gonna be streaming it?
No, this is not a stream game, unfortunately. But I'm still very excited to play. So
I mean, that's rough. Being orc is super rough.
Yeah, it's a tough life, but you know, someone's gotta live it.
It's true, someone does have to live orc life.
Orcs have to live it.
Orcs
do. We even know exactly who has to do it. Yeah.
It's very clear.
Apparently, the 3D version of Force Awakens came out, and everyone but me got it today. What's up with that, guys? Why didn't you, like, pro-tip me on that?
Well, it technically came out on Tuesday, but then it showed up at my
shipping,
door.
Right.
Yeah.
I got that Amazon really Prime, fun. Though. Which is why I know I got my Pokemon Moon today, and I'm going to get my Final Fantasy 15 on the 29th.
See, listen. But what I do is I just go buy it, the physical, and then when it comes from Amazon, I return the other one.
Whoa. No.
Wow.
That's how pre-owned games are born, everybody. That's how it happens.
I'm just saying, I don't feel like...
What a monster.
You know what that does to the games industry?
But I pre-ordered it 3 years ago, so I'm paying $49.98 Canadian.
What if everyone was buying your books at books, your game at bookstores, and then ordering it online, and then going back and returning it, and then they had to sell it at a lower price, so then no one wanted to buy your books online because they could go to get it used at a bookstore, and then you don't get any money.
Wow, that's insane. I mean, as you know, when you take a book out of the bookstore, it loses 15% of its value.
It happened 5 times in my entire life. Okay, give me Final Fantasy 15.
Final Fantasy 15, give me. Listen, I read that Final Fantasy 15 will offer no branching story paths, and the dialogue options give you nothing.
I read that it's co-op play from DLC.
I mean, I would actually like to see that.
Yeah.
I'd be curious, though. Would you all have to play as Noctis?
None. DLC is multiple different characters, right? So you'll be doing stuff from their perspective or something.
Oh, okay. Interesting. I'll wait around to see it. There's a cat hanging out on Kelsa Cam. All right. Speaking of cats, we got to wrap this up. One more Pokemon Moon thing before we go to Virgil. Let me tell you something about this professor. There have been professors in Pokemon before. In fact, every Pokemon game has this professor, but none have had this guy.
I heard he's not getting a passing grade.
When he first came out, everyone was like, look at how hot this dude is. He walks around without a shirt on. Well, guess what? He's a creepster. He walks around without a shirt on, and what? He rings your doorbell, and as you go to open the door, you're halfway across the room, he just bursts in, and is like, what's up? It's me, bro. Every single time. Other people come to knock on your door, they wait on the porch for you to go to them. This guy is always invading your house. It happens like 3 times in the first 10 minutes. I'm like, dude, you need to step outside. Respect our personal space. We just moved here. I don't even know you.
AP, why didn't you lock the door?
I wish I could lock the door. If it was a tabletop RPG, I wouldn't be getting a restraining order, man. I'd be really worried about how much this guy likes being inside our house. That's all I'm saying. Virgil, speaking of people who like to be inside houses, let's talk to you.
Love being in houses, first of all. Totally better than sleeping in like a bush or under a tree. For my money, anyways, you do you. I do me, which is a lot of role-playing games on the internet. If you're enjoying Gerald Seedlington performance, you can catch plenty more silly stuff. You can follow me at twitch.tv/zircon5 for all that good stuff. My week's been mellow, working on a little bit of music stuff. Working actually a bunch on setting up the in-game game for Arthur's new...
The Sprawl, yeah.
Sprawl Cafe. Text RP. God, it's way too hard to even describe what I'm doing.
So but what it is fun. We have a play-by-post game, and inside the play-by-post, Virgil is running a video game that is also a play-by-post. He is running a nested RPG inside of an RPG.
Inside of his Sprawl Cyber game, I'm running a Dungeons & Dragons game.
I'm kind of excited for this.
It's like the Russian Matryoshka dolls. I think that's what they're called.
The nesting dolls?
Nesting dolls.
An arcade cabinet, so it's competing for high score.
Yeah, that was the key seller, I think, for a lot of people, was that you would be scoring people based on like completion time and item usage.
That's pretty great.
All right. Anything else we need to discuss? Anyone else have any quick Pokemon Moon pro tips they want to share?
No.
All right.
Never start playing that game.
Oh, if you surf on the coast, The Bar Island.
No, that's poker. No, we're out. We're out. That's so far back. So there is a hallowed tradition among mouse guard players, so hallowed that it's an actual mechanic in the game, called the prologue. The prologue is something one player delivers at the start of each session. When you start a session, one player may offer up the prologue. When delivering it, you describe to the group what happened last session. If the group is satisfied and well-reminded, you may alleviate a condition, such as hungry, thirsty, angry, or tired, or recover a point of tax nature. Now, knowing what I do about prologuing, I'm gonna just offhandly suspect that Virgil is ready to prologue. But I want to remind you, you cannot prologue two sessions in a row, which means that someone else will have to prologue next time. Virgil, are you in fact ready to prologue?
I am ready.
Why don't you well remind us and satisfy our curiosities of what happened last time?
Last time when we played, we started towards our stated destination with mail in hand and what else in hand? Basically just the mail. And our high morals as well. And all was good until we reached the said bridge that was completely washed away. After pushing through the snow and sleet, we finally arrived to the destroyed bridge and began stacking supplies to rebuild. Luckily, there were nearby large stones and whatnot. And after a nice group effort, we lodged them into place and were finally able to easily traverse back and forth so that the other mice could as well. The guard prevails.
The guard prevails.
However, we were approached by a... wait, was it a ferret?
Vicious ferret.
A ferret. I still suspect it's a weasel that lied. But one of our mice is very knowledgeable about weasels, so maybe he would have saw through the disguise. Anyways, this guy was like, this weasel was like, I'm like a princess, super important, and you should. I just look in for, you know, your mouse cities there. So if you want to take me along, I'd be, you know, super grateful. It'd be a good idea. Safety in numbers. And I was like, there's probably numbers of our mousy kind in your belly. And I scampered up a tree. The others talked for a while and were convinced that it's probably safe to bring them along. So for a while we traveled. I convinced the group to lead out of the way a bit. And then we kind of were like, all right, off that way, and slunk off and successfully made it all the way. What's the town name? Spruce? Not Spruce Town. Was it north of Apple Loft somewhere?
Sivydale.
What else do you guys? Oh, there it is.
Lockhaven,
right. So happy to arrive safe and sound. We did a few little chores, delivered the mail. We went to go send messages back about not only completing the bridge and that there was now a way to get back, but this ferret weasel princess problem. Meanwhile, Arturo and Marigold got up their bravery and headed out to try to track down the princess and engage in battle. It was not going well for our mouse heroes, but luckily they managed to escape, not without taking some harm.
Well, but, we won the fight.
Well, didn't the princess kind of run?
Yeah,
off?
Yeah, they split.
Oh. We both took concessions. It was, I mean, neither one of us are dead, so in that way we won, but she's not dead either, so.
Right, so we didn't quite slay the beast, but at least we kind of ran the beast out of where it was, so they might be happy about that. Yeah, and then we're all in, back in town safely and sound.
Okay.
That's where we dropped it.
Does everyone feel satisfied and well reminded?
I feel super satiated.
Very well. Virgil, Gerald may recover a point of tax nature or recover one of his conditions except injured or sick.
Nature. There it is.
So, we begin about a month later in the town of Ivydale. You've been performing patrol tasks in and around Ivydale. The Mouse Guard has no authority within the city, so you aren't, like, tasked with police service. You just, you know, help clean things up. Outside the city, you continue to make sure that the spring doesn't ruin the road. General protection, chasing away small animals, which are larger than you. We would consider them small animals.
Okay. Vicious insects and whatnot.
Yes, the mosquitoes. You are approached by the Mouse Guard, the Armorer of Lockhaven, a mouse by the name of Midnight, who is a black fur. He's slightly larger than the normal mouse, and he is always seen wearing a series of iron strips, which are then placed, like, partially covering. It's like a form of very heavy armor. It's not totally covering, but it does look fairly intimidating. Midnight approaches your team and says, "Guards of the Mouse Guard, I am Midnight, the Armorer of Lockhaven, and I have a mission for you."
All right, tell us more.
Who is the leader here? I recognize none of you.
I am the leader.
What's your name and rank?
Bartholomew, Guard Patrol Leader.
I've heard of you.
Oh.
Very well. There's a problem on the western roads between Ivydale and Elmas. Some Shelborough merchants, apparently. It's been rumored that they're hijacking grain shipments, paying ne'er-do-wells to kick the wheels off of carts from Elmas and Ivydale. What I can tell, if this is true, it's in an attempt to help set prices, give them a better cut. I want you to search the roads between here and Elmas. Make sure it's not true. And if it is true, well, the guard should do something about it. I think you agree.
I'm sure we all do. That needs to be rectified. And we will do it.
Good.
I immediately start nervously playing with the chopped off end of my tail.
I just start, like, you know, holding the bow, twirling around a little bit.
There's more. Normally, I wouldn't assign this task to another group. I would go and deal with it myself. But there's a second objective that needs to be done. At the intersection of the roads from Shelborough, Ivydale, and Elmas, an enormous frog has taken up residence on the road. It's been coming out of the swamps there and attacking mouse carts, taking their grain.
That's not normal.
It's been known. It's been known to eat the beetles.
Gotcha.
So, in this realm, beetles are kind of like dogs for mice. They're semi-intelligent. They can be used to carry things and fetch things. They're also, like, particularly large beetles used to pull wagons.
Yeah. Okay.
I know a bit about frogs. Can I kind of, like, spout? I'm not sure.
Spout lower.
I want to spout some stuff about frogs.
I mean, you have frog-wise.
So, do I have to roll, or should
no,
I say something?
I mean, if it sounds reasonable to me, I'll let it stand.
Oh, well, thing is, frogs, they like flying things, and little crawling things, and, if something's been dead, then there'll be flies around it, and then you'll see frogs around it. maybe if something's dead in the swamp, we can make it go over there and eat flies.
That's a solid plan.
I thought you were going to ride it.
Do any of you speak frog?
To the swamp. Do you speak frog?
And so, speaking the language of another animal is lower mouse. Sorry.
Oh, I think I might do that then. Let's see.
Oh yeah, I have two in lower mouse.
Lower mouse.
I do not.
I have two in it as well. Okay. Same.
So I'm just gonna let you know up front. speaking with beasts of the water is extremely difficult, and is a difficulty 5 lower mouse test.
But I could like fork in frog or something, right?
Yes, you could frog-wise, which means you don't get the condition hit. You give them an extra dice without being attached to the consequences.
And I could help you with...
Lore mouse.
I'm just like...
Will I speak a bit? I know how to say faster, slower, lift, right? Jump, don't jump quite so hard, please.
This will be the arrival episode of Mouseguard, where we formulate a new language to talk to this frog.
Man, I haven't seen that movie yet.
I haven't seen that movie yet either.
It was amazing.
Well,
I believe that.
I might have to go check it out then.
Yeah. But yeah. Well, I'll tell the blacksmith that his mission is safe with us. We have the skills required for this mission, and we'll do Ivydale proud.
He's not a blacksmith. He's an armorer.
The armorer.
Very large difference. He's like the head of the blacksmiths. He makes sure everybody has a weapon and armor.
Esteemed Ivydale citizen.
So he's just says, the guard prevails.
The guard prevails.
And says, Captain Bartholomew, can I speak to you?
Of course. And I like sidle over. I have like a little crinkled mouse brow as I'm worried about what he might say.
Where are you from, Bartholomew?
I'm from Port Sumac.
So you're not from around here. No. It's a lot of problems between Ivydale, Elmas, and Shaleboro. A lot of local problems. Anybody on your team a local?
That's a good question.
If you don't know offhand, he immediately is like, this is the kind of things a guard captain should know.
Right. We're just a new patrol, but you're right. I should know, and I will know going forward.
That's good. I want to talk to you about the issue of loyalty. These cities, especially Sherylboro, haven't been donating as much to the guard as they might. I think these same merchants who you might find are causing problems might not be as loyal to the idea of the Mouse Guard as they could be.
I see.
How does that make you feel?
Well, I feel like loyalty is of the utmost importance, or else the guard will not prevail. It'll shatter against the rocks. Loyalty is one of our first and only defenses against the betrayal that once happened hundreds of years ago, if you know your history.
Yeah, he narrows his eyes at you and says, that's right. Unity is very important. He puts one of his little mousy paws on your shoulder and looks into your eyes in the way that makes you think that this scene will almost certainly be a flashback in the future, and says, unity is more important than anything else. We need to bring all mice together.
Agreed. If you think the situation is so dire, I will do what I can. Is there any other indications that you think unity is fragile or breaking? Or is this a gut reaction to what's happening locally?
So he like pats you on the back, and rather than answer your question, he just says, use any means necessary.
Okay. What fur color does he have?
Black.
black. Okay. Does he have nice eyes, though? Kind eyes?
No. No. Okay. He has dark obsidian eyes. Yeah. This is a mouse of war.
Okay.
This is a mouse forged out of the Weasel Wars.
Gotcha. Okay. I think I'll move away and kind of give like a nod and go back to the companions. But my mouse little furried mark there over my forehead when I'm worried is grown even more predominant.
Okay. So each of you will need to write a goal for this mission.
So yeah, I have one.
Let's talk about your belief, your instinct, and your goal, just in case you need to change any of them.
Oh, yeah.
Gerald, you got a goal?
I'm going to actually change it to find alternative food for the bulldog.
Okay. Any change to your instinct or...
No, my instincts don't take risks. My belief is every job is important, and that sometimes helping is staying out of the way.
Okay.
I've got a goal. solve the frog problem quick so we can get on with the other missions. And my belief is the guard knows what's right, and my instinct is I run towards the danger.
It's rough. It's hard being that kind of mouse.
I also have a goal.
Is it get a pet ladybug?
I mean, it wasn't, but now it is. my actual goal is to get the party safely to Elmas.
Dangerous goal.
I know. And note, I did not say uninjured as we start off injured, but not further hurt.
Perfect. All right.
In no worse and possibly better condition.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, it's the Boy Scout way.
Can you do something about us being hurt?
No. Yes, you have to use checks to do it.
I have to use a check. During our...
Which neither of us have.
You have to survive until the player turn, buddy.
So, fun times.
Yeah. So, yeah. And my belief is I can make the world a better place, one good deed at a time. And instinct, I will always put others' safety before my own.
Okay. Bartholomeus, guard captain of the Mouse Guard.
For goal, I'm thinking bind the loyalty of the party together through my own action and words. Because it seems like we're probably a little... Like, I think we need some unity as well after what happened last time.
Yeah, you wanna do some team bonding, some like Inquisition stuff. I get it.
Well, not Inquisition stuff, but some bonding, yeah. Instinct, I'm wondering if I should keep it with always confer with my comrades before acting. I think that's a good one. Belief, there's no task we cannot complete together, I think it's still the same. So maybe just a new goal. Does that sound good?
Okay. You set off out of Ivydale.
Before we set off, because we kind of just, kind of got pulled across, what's his name? The armorer?
Midnight.
By Midnight.
Midnight.
So when I see that they're done with like whatever conversation, I've been like lollygagging around the door, kicking at like little dust motes. And when I see they're finished, I walk over and I just say,
Midnight, I was just very impressed with the armor. It's quite nice.
Yes.
My good friend Goliath is actually the armor in Barkstone. You know of him?
I know a lot of people.
Oh, well, he's pretty talented as well. Showed me a few things while I was over there.
You know, I'll have to head to Barkstone and maybe talk to him. What'd you say his name was?
His name's Goliath.
Goliath.
Big strong mouse.
It's a good strong name.
Anyways, yes, we'll be off then on your little adventure. I don't suppose maybe you had a little bit of maybe protective armor laying around the size of a small mouse like myself.
Yeah, he does have such stuff. If it exists in the rule book, he has it because he's an armorer.
Makes sense.
I actually don't know if there is such a thing.
Mouse armor.
Wait, yeah. As I like continue onwards, I'm like,
I feel just like a pauldron or two, as it were.
I mean, you're thinking like plate armor. That's
no,
way more
I know. I'm just joking around. I don't know if we have like a leather shirt or some sort.
Yeah, like he's got wooden. The most advanced armor that you've seen, which is just.
I want like birch bark.
Heavy armor can be worn. It absorbs 1 point of damage struck by a weapon during a conflict. It gives you -1 to maneuver and scout, and -1 to health tests against fatigue.
Okay. Yeah. I would totally take it if he had some.
Yeah. He gets you some like woven bark armor, and now you look ridiculous. It's like giant like shoulder pads, and then it's completely exposed until down to the wrists, where it forms like bucklers on both of your on your wrists, and then it's like. Two sections of wood and then a bunch of sections of wood around your stomach and then it like a wooden kilt around your legs.
That's awesome. That's amazing.
I think when you like
you look
up,
like a whole new mouse, but it just weighs so much.
Yeah. You like lock up when or like do you is this like right before we leave?
Yeah, he gets a palette change when he switches classes from Tender Paw to
palaching.
Yeah, so
he like maybe like locks up or like kind of like slowly like thunks up to the party, and I think Arturo just starts laughing. He starts like and like he's like and then just loses it.
Like, well, I thought you'd be hippie. Now I don't have to run up a tree every time something with a sharp claw comes by.
I think you look very safe, Gerald.
Thank you for the compliment.
No problem. Okay, so are we ready to set out?
Well, now I am.
Awesome.
Okay, as you set out into the spring weather from Ivydale, everything looks fine to start with. It's a little chill, and it's a little misty, but it just adds an air of delightful mystery to your travels through to Shaleborough and Elmos's roads. However, when you reach the first intersection, 2 days into your travels, you hear the shouting before you see what's happening, and as your party approaches... You see a flag of Elmos being wove from atop a cart that is tilted sideways, and they're doing the Washington crossing the Delaware, where like the one mouse is like waving the flag of this like grain cart, and several mice have drawn weapons against what appear to be a Shaleborough cart that's completely unloaded. There's nothing on it, but rather tough-looking mice. You know, a lot of them have scars. They have pretty serious-looking weapons and armor. They seem very relaxed, unlike the Elmos mice, who are all look like they're ready to start a war.
Mice against mice? This is not the way. We need to intervene.
I agree. Mice shall never kill mice. Or mouse, I suppose.
This is what the guard is for.
Are there any like unarmed, like just, are there any just like women or children or like people that are?
I mean, there are women there, but they're on both sides of the conflict.
Okay.
There's no children involved in this.
Okay. But there's not also like unarmed people. It's like two crowds.
Yeah, it's two crowds. There are several unarmed people among the merchants, but they're like holding menacing rocks or something. They're like, So yeah, you're hearing a lot of shouts from the Shelboro folk like, we didn't do anything. Why are you blaming us for this? Get out the road so we can continue on our way. And the Elmas contingent is like, we know you wrecked our wagon. Stop lying about it, you Shelboroists. Why don't you go hide in the ground some more?
Shelbers.
Yeah, I think Marigold is going to come forward since it seems like no one else is.
Oratorian it up.
Announce our party. And it's going to be like, pardon me. We're here from the guard. We're more than happy to help deliberate a dispute.
So all of the mice that are in the wagon, the Shelboro wagon, are immediately like, oh, and roll their eyes and just start filing out of the wagon and doing like some, you know, they're like, oh, okay, this isn't going anywhere. We're just going to like get out the wagon now. And they're like working out some exercise stuff real quick. The wagon driver of the Shelboro contingent kind of hops down from his like beetle perch and begins approaching you. The Elmos contingent, like they're all like, yeah, the guard is here. You're going to get yours now, Shelburians.
I'm totally unsure of what I should be doing, so I'm like kind of checking the wheels of the.
I know someone.
Even remove the wheels of this one.
So yeah, what the Elmos cart, one of the wheels spokes is cracked, and in turn, like that section of the wheel has also cracked, so it won't like go properly. Oh. It got caught on a rock and stopped turning.
My senior artisan is from Shelboro, so I believe that means I spent time there, right?
No, that means that he, when he was from Shelboro and went to Lockhaven and you spent time with him. You could have been in Shelboro for sure.
I'm pretty sure, because... No, that's the only connection I have to Shelboro.
Okay, well... Yeah, I mean, you when you get a senior artisan, it's during your time as a Tenderpaw in Lockhaven.
Gotcha.
Mm-hmm.
I'm scampering about looking for reeds or some type of, like a willow tree that you can pull like strips of thin strips of fibers.
Oh, you're way more likely to find reeds than you are to find an enormous willow tree. Yeah,
well, I mean a lot willow trees grow near like creeks pretty often in like small little things, and then they don't get very big because there's too much shade.
We must have seen very different willow
here,
trees.
A lot of small ones in the wetlands. Yeah, so I'll look for some reeds, and if I can like chew a couple down, and run them back to that wagon wheel and start fussing about over there, while these guys are talking.
Yeah, do you have any like wagon repairing skills?
No, I just have weaver, so I'm just gonna try to like weave like a
yeah. After we'll come back to it, but it's ultimately a futile attempt.
Okay.
But yeah, everyone like the Elmos people are like, I've never heard of this before. Is this a secret guard technique to like weave reed into a wheel? And they're all super excited. They think it's, you know, like secret ninja technique number 4.
I'm going to walk over to the Shelburians and see what's going on.
Okay.
I'm telling everyone that this is how you fix a broken frog leg, so it'll surely work on a cart.
Bartholomeus, Marigold. Marigold, you kind of announced yourself, and yeah. The Shelboro leader is coming to you.
Good. Brilliant.
What are the two of you doing?
I'll ask Marigold if she wants like my help talking to them. Otherwise I could maybe put my skills to work helping repair the wheel as well. whatever she thinks is best, because I'm conferring with you.
Do you actually have any skills with repairing a wagon wheel? I know you're quite a skilled raider, but I wasn't sure how your carpentry was.
I've got carpentry too, and I've got roadwise. I don't know if that would help.
It sounds like you may actually be better suited to help repair the wheel. I think you've got a better chance of it than little Gerald does.
Over. It looks like I have it like half wrapped for Christmas.
Yeah, great. Okay, yeah, I see that, and I nod and I'll say I'm always going to be within earshot if you need me, but I trust that you know whatever you do will be the right thing.
And just to clarify, Sam, you were having Arturo's going over to the other delegation.
Okay. Yeah, just to.
So. Yeah.
Get the other side of the story.
Here's the thing. The Elmos haven't sent anybody to speak with you, Marigold. The Shaleboro right. leader is coming to you.
Right.
Arturo is going to the Shaleburians.
Yeah. No, I thought he was going to the
I thought he was
No, I was going to the Shaleburians, but I could be going to the Elmosians when I see that they're
Elmosians.
Elmosarians.
Elmosarians.
Does Marigold just keep looking at them? Like, go over there.
I'll go over to the Elmosarians.
Yeah.
Just like teaching the whiskers in the direction, right?
And I'll go like meet the Shellbrook leader halfway so that, you know,
So he has, it's not a guard cape cloak, but it is like a, like, wrapping that he's wearing, and he's got a belt that he like hitches up around his belly, which kind of wobbles.
Mm-hmm.
And there's various tools hanging from it, you know, like a hammer, like some sort of like sealed saw, a small like paring knife, that kind of stuff. He looks like a pretty handy mouse, even if he is a little pudgy. And he just takes a big snort and then twitches his whiskers and says, name's Rind. Me and my boys are just looking to get to Ivydale. Hope you can resolve these Elmos citizens who seem to have waylaid us here.
I'd be more than happy to help out. That's what the guard's for. My name is Marigold Fairweather, and, why don't you tell me what happened here?
We were camping nearby last night. We knew the Elmos were in the area. We came over to trade a bit. They turned us away, saying some crazy talk about sabotage and waylaying. Accused my men of being bandits. It's disrespectful. We just wanted to trade a bit of grain. Maybe a bit of mead, some honey, some Elmos specialty products, you understand. Shellboro's getting its trading in early, but we're not traders. We're just simple guards. We woke up this morning. The Elmos were screaming about how we'd injured their wagon, how we must have made the wheel go defective, remove the spoke. We came this way to see if we could help them out. And they spent the last hour accusing us of all manner of unpleasantries. We're just looking to get to Ivydale. We stopped to help them. And now they won't let us pass. They're taking the whole road up.
I see. And what about the goods that you were carrying in your wagon? It seems rather empty.
Yeah, he points to his men. He's like, those are the goods. Shellboro offers very highly trained guard mice for those in the territories who don't rely on the mouse guard or need extra protection for their caravans on call.
I imagine they're just going full Ginsu force behind it, like,
yeah, okay, sure. I thought they were going to be a bit more professional, but yeah, they're all flexing. When Marigold looks over, a lot of them start flexing, like, yeah, we're pretty professional.
We put most of our goods over that way.
Is that something I could know how true that statement is about sending trained?
Yeah, it's fairly. Trauma? Yeah, it's definitely something they're reputed to do. It's a bit at odds with the mouse guard, and often the guard will go for free because, you know, they are paid in taxes on a mission that these guards are already on. And it causes some friction in both directions because this is how these guys make their money. You know, the mouse guard isn't assigned to villages. They kind of wander between them. And sometimes people need priority shipments done or just don't trust the guard in general. And so Shelboro, you know, guards are available for hire. For coin.
Gotcha.
I see. Well, let's see if we can get their wheel fixed and get them out of your way so you can get on your way.
Thank you, Miss Fairgold.
Marigold.
Marigold, right.
And then, like, I'll walk over to where Arturo is already talking to the Elmossians.
Elmissarians.
Yeah, let's start that conversation and then we'll cut in with you joining. Yeah,
have me jump in when appropriate.
So I approach and I say, "Hello, Elmissarians."
We just prefer to call ourselves Elmos citizens, and a lot of them are like, "No, Elmissarian sounds great." And someone else is like, "My grandfather founded Elmos."
I'll say, why did you not send someone to treat with us?
They're like, "We have to defend." And then, like, the mouse that's up with the flag is like, "No, no, I've got this." And he hops down and kind of struts over towards you. He's wearing a cloak, but again, it's not a mouse guard cloak. It has the, like, seal of Elmos on the back. And he, like, half turns dramatically towards you so that the seal flutters out briefly in the wind. And then he turns his nose up at you and says, "I am Bertrand of Elmos, a simple trader of grain and peddler of like. My fellow citizens and I were simply passing through the area when we were set upon in the night by these brigands from Shaleboro. We did not come to treat with you because someone must keep an eye on them. It is said in Elmos that you must keep two eyes on a Shaleboroian in times like these."
What was your name again one more time?
Bertrand of Elmos.
Bertrand, be honest with me. You practiced that cape flutter thing in the mirror, right?
He looks very sourly at you. And there's some mutterings among his men. Some of them are like nodding like, "Yeah, he definitely did." And the others are like, "That was very disrespectful." Like,
I'm like, no, I'm just joking around. But seriously, that's a big problem. What makes you think that they're bandits?
Everyone knows Shaleboro mice are bandits. Little better than wolves. In the night, they came and disabled our wagon so that it would break when we went over that particular rock. Someone remove that spoke. Probably in the background, we now see that like the entire wheel is just being covered in reeds until it looks like a cheese rind.
Yeah, great.
Well, once we get you back on the road, it doesn't seem... Did they take anything?
Nay. We were on watch. They probably didn't have the ability to take any of our grain. Some of it has gone into the mud since the cart was overturned, but we'll recover as much as we can.
Well, just between you and me, I don't think bandits are interested in throwing goods into the mud. I think we're just going to fix your wheel and you're going to get going.
He's like, "No, nay. We won't go anywhere without justice for Elmos. You can't let these shell burrows push us around. I thought you were part of the Mouse Guard. You're supposed to defend us from things like this. If you hadn't come here, who knows what they could have done? Surrounded us, tried to take our goods, silenced us.
What I do know, sir, is what they did do. They did not attack you. Perhaps they did break your wheel, and we shall investigate. But for now, I'm sure you have places to go, a busy trader like yourself.
I feel like now's a great time for Marigold to come over. This guy looks like he's settling in for a good argument with Arturo. He's not backing down from this accusation that Shellboro is behind their misfortune.
Yeah, he's pulled out a podium. He's already making notes.
Hi there. My name is Marigold, and I'm so sorry I didn't catch your name, Mr. Elmas Citizen.
So what he does is he pivots fully around on his right leg so that the cape is, like, his back is to you, so the cape is on full display, and then turns until he's profile in the other direction and says, Bertrand!
Really impressive.
Of Elmas.
Did you ever do that?
My mother knitted this for me before she died.
How tragic.
My mother always said, add potatoes to your tomato sauce in case it's too salty, and never let a shell burrow get away with your goods.
I agree with the first one. I haven't heard of the second one that often, but We're gonna help you get that wheel fixed right up and on your way.
Very well, but what will you do about these bandits who have beset us and plagued our land?
We'll take care of it. That's none of your business. That's our job.
He's like, he gestures to his his card. He's like, it's all of our business. It's literally the only business there is.
Hold protection. On a moment. Why don't you tell me a little bit about what happened?
He repeats the same story as before.
How long ago how long have you been standing here at this impasse?
He's like, for over an hour. We have
for
been
7 days.
We've been preparing to defend ourselves from these shell burrow antagonists.
And at no point did they actually attack you?
They're preparing for it. Just look at them. They're like currently like stretching like
none of them
like
had weapons out when we when
yeah
we...
no one had weapons out. He's like right. They're preparing now even while we look and on.
None of them have their weapons out at all.
You should definitely arrest them.
Arrest them. For over an hour, you stood up to the you stood here in the road and never attacked. That doesn't sound like bandits at all. When I've come across bandits in the past, they've struck very quickly and without warning.
Also, your wheel was hit by a rock.
So, I feel like it's time to talk some sense to this guy, and I feel like Marigold has been leading the charge here, but feel free to have anybody sub in for a persuader role.
I was going to try to manipulate him. That's like kind of what I was going for. I was kind of trying to control him at first.
You were like, listen, your problem isn't a problem. This is none of your business. I don't specifically know that that's a manipulator.
Well, I was trying to go with like more like the intimidate.
Yeah,
side.
I mean, it would have been intimidation, but the Mouse Guard doesn't intimidate people, which is why it's not really a skill.
Yeah. But like, I thought manipulator was that.
I mean, yes. If you wanna sub into the front and manipulate him by being like, "We'll deal with it, and it's none of your business."
Let me see how good I am.
Oh, capture the Batman.
I prefer talking him down.
Yeah, I'm only like 2 dice in manipulator anyway, so that's probably
that's also what I have. Would you like to help me?
Your dice pool tell you how to roleplay, man.
It's like your character sheet tells you what your character is good at, Virgil.
Not what that's for.
So, I mean, I would say that him backing up with the don't worry, we'll take care of them would be him assisting me if with manipulate if sure. That would give me an extra die.
Yeah.
Cool.
All right. You are looking for obstacle 3.
This is not going to be easy.
I feel like my inquisitive trait is not something I could use in my own favor here. I feel like this is pretty important, but I don't.
You could use inquisitive against yourself by being like, listen, I literally don't care. we just need you to get off the road.
Jeez, no, I can't do that. I can't do that.
Looks like someone doesn't want to earn any checks. I'm curious, how does your injury...
Oh no, don't forget we're both hurt.
Yeah, which means you give 0 dice.
No.
The epic music just started.
No.
No, because I still have 1 die to help with.
Oh, jeez.
I think that when you're... Right. Oh no, that's for conflicts.
You can still do it.
What it is if you're injured, you give a -1 to disposition during a conflict, which means you give nothing. But yes, you can still land an aid die.
But I lose a die.
Yes, you do.
Okay, I guess in that case I will use... I don't think inquisitive against myself would make sense. I think maybe determined against myself.
Okay, yeah, I'll take it. You're basically lining up to intentionally fail this roll to give yourself a check.
Yep. I mean, I already can't.
Yeah, it's already a fail.
So I might as well just take a dive, right?
Nice. Got a success at least.
I mean.
Oh,
see, that's why I don't let the dice pool tell me what's up.
Well, you could
the dice tell you.
You could hope that you roll another 6 and then a 4.
Faint. It comes like water, man.
Well, let's do it. I'm determined. Let's do this.
Yeah. Right.
Natural law.
No,
that was a mistake. All right, well, that was a fate well spent.
It's fine. Don't worry about it.
You never know if it's going to be well spent.
Don't worry. You'll get that epiphany soon. Wait, this isn't that system. So, while you're explaining it to them, Bertrand is eventually like, all right, okay, listen, that kind of seems like a good idea. When you hear a krakoom noise, like, and the sky overhead is rapidly darkening, and everyone's just like, cover the grain! Quickly! The shell burrow pitch in to help cover the cart, and get it all gathered together. And the Elmoths seem to have put aside their, you know, differences to get this done. But all of you are caught in the open during a freak spring rain.
Ooh.
It's a lot like a chocolate rain, but colder.
Okay. I'm trying to show Bartholomew, you were coming over to help with the wheel, right?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
So right before the raindrops, I'm just like showing him what I've done, and I'm like,
so I've got right over here a classic splint for a friction frog leg, and on the ixels I've done each one for like a sprain set for frog ankle, and it's all tied into the spoke right here.
And then it all just explodes and comes off the wheel.
Yeah. So we don't have time to fix the wheel, though?
And then it's like...
You can't fix the wheel. The cart's not going to... Like, it's not going to be immediate. You're all caught in this rain.
The chocolate rain.
Yes.
This time you're feeling the pain.
Do you what? Do you have carpentry or boatswain or something like that?
I have both of those, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you could roll one. It's an ob 2 to get this cart rolling again.
Okay, I have... Could I do a carpenter fort with boat, crafter fort with roadwise?
That's not even close to how that works.
Well, roadwise seems like it makes sense.
I mean, that no. There's no forking. This isn't forkable. Roadwise would be if someone else was doing it, you could lean over to them and just be like, that's not how you do that. This is how you do it.
I've got weasel eyes.
Can I fork in cunning?
There's no forking. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Okay. Can
I, burning will light.
Since Gerald's right there.
Gerald,
right?
I mean, all of you can help. This is post discussion. Oh, sure. This is during the rain. You're pitching in together.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll help. I mean, I'm injured, but I will still help.
What do you guys have to help with? Let's talk about how it's happening.
I have potted.
Sorry, what was it? I heard both of you at the same time and didn't understand it. Sam, what do you got?
I don't have anything helpful.
Kelsa?
Scientist?
I'll take it. Yeah, that'll help.
What about, do we need supplies for this?
No, it's just going to take a bit of work to get it together.
Do you have laborer?
Laborer would help.
I've got harvester.
No.
Will you
take survivalist help?
I don't think so.
I have laborer.
Yeah, you can step in and help with laborer.
Yeah. So I'll just like hold things in place to, you know, for him and stuff.
So I want to remind everybody during the last failed roll, make sure to mark your fails. And yeah, we have a help from Gerald and Marigold. How are each of you helping? How are you sciencing? How are you laboring?
I'm laboring by like holding heavy pieces of wood in place while they're like.
Oh, you're the wheeljack. You're the guy that's like holding the cart up out of the mud so that they can get under it.
I am scientisting by measuring twice and cutting once.
Yeah.
You've got like your tape measure out. You're like, okay, all right.
Yeah, and I want to cut like a piece of wood that barely fits so that when the cart starts rolling, it just goes on the axle and it's like a temporary fix.
Perfect. Okay, roll your dice.
Oh, that didn't work.
So close. Just one mistake.
No rollings, just roll.
Yeah, that's like the old... Wait, how do you do it? You go / roll.
Okay.
20.
Perfect. Okay. Everyone mark a success down.
Rolling 20.
You ever seen that?
No.
Dom used to do that during Pathfinder for the longest time. And I was like, you know, it seems impossible that you would crit on every single attack for the last 5 attacks. And then I checked this macro and was like, you didn't put in roll d20. You just put roll 20, buddy.
So I mark of... past carpenter.
Yep.
And I get a pass to my scientist, which puts me at 2 passes and 1 fail, and I advance the scientist 3.
Perfect.
Whoa.
More science.
Science. So the future science. Is now.
She
blinded me with science. Da, 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 da.
Yeah.
So I cut like this like pizza shaped cog in there, put it in, and then it starts rolling and gets tucked in there the more that it rolls.
Everybody's too cold and too wet to argue, and both teams go in their opposite directions. Unfortunately, all of you have been working out in the rain.
Can we like start singing a song like in The Hobbit when they're all around the hearth?
Yeah.
Sort of, like, hearten ourselves up.
Yes, and then you can make OB3 health tests that the injured people lose a die on.
Can I make a test to help everyone by making a fire or something?
Yeah, you can aid everyone's health test with health.
Oh, well, let's do that.
What?
Can we all help each other with health tests?
Yes, just like last time, you can do that. Again. But you're also prone to the failures of those tests.
Here's the thing, though. I need failures and I don't need passes.
Living a dangerous life.
Wow, you know that's
you're like you're like a Saiyan. You're like, if I can just almost die, I'll get way stronger.
That's a really good point.
But I feel like we should do it because it'll increase our unity after the fracturedness.
Like you should do it because it will earn me a point of Varsha.
you look over and you see that as I'm like. As I'm like trying to like reposition myself to sit down, I have to like stand up and like move my soaking wet armor.
Oh yeah, that would be terrible.
Well, but
I look pretty miserable, and I probably can't help anyone.
If you have health four,
I'm at a minus one, and Sam is at a minus one.
Well, if you're at a health four, you need four passes and four failures, is it?
Three failures.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just gonna roll my three dice and see what happens.
Okay, so you're not accepting help from anybody?
Yes, correct.
All right.
Oh no, this is the end of Unity Squad.
Yeah.
Oh man.
That's a fail. Oh.
Man, it's really
spend it.
All my fate already.
Oh no!
I don't have any fate. I'm all out.
Oh no! I have bad news for you, Kelsa Mouse. What? Cute little Marigold is shivering, and then she starts sneezing, and it's clear that she is sick.
Oh no!
You need to eat right and keep warm and dry because you are ill.
Okay, so we're not helping each other, I guess, because everybody's rolling.
Arturo's in the same boat. Arturo, what? Like,
should I spend the fate?
Yes, probably. Being sick is not good.
But I don't get to. All right, I'll put it. It's a 50-50 chance. We'll see what happens.
Did it again?
Yeah.
Nope. Arturo, you're just soaked down to the bone. Your cloak is doing nothing for you. No one can get a fire going with all of this wetness. And you're all caught, not exactly in the open, but the area around you was a marsh to begin with. It's not like anything's going to burn. Maybe you're all gathered under a leaf, but the ground is just so soaking wet. And you're just shivering in the cold like a tiny sick mouse.
So I got two successes on an ob 3. That means I just fail, right?
Yep. You are also sickened by this.
Okay, well, but I can spend a persona to roll more dice, or is that only before?
I think it has to be before.
Okay.
Let me double check on that.
It might be a reroll for persona.
Mm.
I can't remember.
Can I have you foolish against myself.
Fate is only
too late.
Used on sixes.
I mean, you would have had to say that beforehand.
Yeah, yeah. And fate is only used for sixes, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Yeah, you're out of luck when you roll successes with no sixes.
Rewards: earning fate, earning persona. Doesn't tell you what persona does.
5d6, no sixes. Bummer.
Let's see here. By spending a persona point, you may add your nature to any ability or skill test. So you could spend your persona and then add your nature to this role.
Yeah, I have two personas. I can spend one, and my nature is six.
Yes, and surviving this would be within your nature, so you don't need to lower it.
Yeah, no tax this time.
No
bro.
Tax. No tax. Go ahead and roll your extra nature die. Bah, 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 bah.
Five successes.
How is it that you succeed so overwhelmingly where your other friends have failed so far?
I know
we haven't gotten to you yet. I'm just saying so far.
So I like end up just like pulling my legs up into the little kind of skirt that is my armor, and then pulling my arms inside the armor too. And then I basically have like a tiny home that's the size of my body. Yeah. I just completely turtle up.
Turtle up. Yeah.
I like seal up the top of it with my scarf. So I'm like all cinched in there.
What's happening with you, Bart? Good old Bart.
I want it to be the song.
Oh, you sing your song of happy times and hobbit days. Yeah, and you get through the wind and the rain without getting overly affected. Everyone is, of course, slickened and covered with water, but not everyone is sick. So being sick gives you a minus one penalty to nature, will, health, and skill test that stacks with your injured rating. So you now have minus two to anything you want to do.
Great.
You seem pretty great. Before you set
off...
Oh,
wait, I get to mark a... Yeah. A successful health check.
Before you guys set off down the road to deal with the frog, I'm curious about the disposition of the party. Like, you have two injured and sick guard mice. None of you work together, and many of you failed. Like, this party has... Like, this discussion with the Shellboro and the Elmo seems to have split the party in half, it goes as far back as the weasel. Like, those who chase the weasel are suffering the karmic fate, perhaps? I feel like there should definitely be a talk about it.
Okay, so I'm definitely like, join the mouse guard, they said. It'll be fun, they said.
You can see your flying colors. It is fun.
Yeah, tiny mice sneezes.
Yeah. Yeah, like what, maybe when it stops, like the downpour, and we can hear each other. I need to like walk in the middle so everybody can hear me, and I say, this guard patrol needs to heal itself, people. We're fractured. We need to hold ourselves accountable for each other and not just ourselves. Hatred destroyed my family.
Achoo!
Yeah.
Dramatic sneeze.
But for real, we should realize that this is about everyone and not just ourselves, and come together, because I care about you all very much, and I don't want to see you suffer any more than you have. And maybe that's when the sneeze happens.
Yeah. I think though, like, I think Arturo sits up a little straighter, and he says, he like coughs a little bit and says, like, he's right. We have to represent the guard. These people might not see guards mice for a while. We need to show them that we know how to get things done.
And I clasp him on the back and I say, Arturo's posture is as stout as his heart. How about you both?
Here, here.
Okay, well, we all need to work together to make sure this frog is safely moved off the road. So it sounds good to me.
Do not think that your contributions are lost on me. I see all of your worth. And that is why the guard prevails.
The guard prevails.
And I throw my scarf over my shoulder dramatically.
Yeah. Just maybe you were studying that guy with the cloak, hey?
I love that the camera would shift dramatically to like show the rising sun in the background, and you're all like standing looking at it, and the scarf is the only piece of like animation going on.
And it's just like gifing.
Yeah, it'd be like it'd be a weird water, like, it would be the full regular animation, and then it just goes to like a watercolor painting of the scarf, just boop, boop, beep, boop, beep, boop. Yeah.
It's Banner Saga time.
Ah, it's Banner Saga time. Yeah, for sure.
I was having like an 8-bit portrait, like late 90s point and click.
We all went to different places.
Yeah, oops.
I like that.
It was all epic, though. Revelated.
Yeah, you continue your journey southward.
Is it still raining?
Oh, yes. It's going to be raining the entire trip.
Can I...
It's not going to be a problem anymore. You've already suffered the ill effects. Is there something else you want to do? You can weather watcher to try to change the weather.
Exactly. That's what I was thinking.
All right. That's a dangerous game to play, my friend.
I know, but I
was... A beneficial yet dangerous game.
I was thinking that maybe it would be... good for the fiction, though, like, we have this talk, right, that's when the sun comes out, kind of thing. It would be epic for the fiction. And I mean
who all can help with the weather watcher here?
Well, let's look at the weather watcher skill, which is its own independent thing. Weather watcher skill is about spotting clouds, knowing direction of wind, blah 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 blah. Suggested help for weather watcher is weather watcher or scientist.
What about weather sense? Because I have that.
I mean, if you're the one making the roll, you don't need to have weather sense. I think weather sense is a trait, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a trait, yeah.
So you could use that for yourself to get an extra die.
Yeah, or I can use it against...
Or you can use it against yourself if you want to intentionally try to... Not necessarily fail. You might have a bunch of dice, but...
Yeah, because I have 4 dice in it.
So let's lay out what the thing is.
Okay.
If you want a weather watcher during the spring, it's ob 6. It's fairly difficult. If you succeed, you can tell me what weather is going to happen.
Okay.
If you win by 2 or more, you can pick weather from any season. That weather starts at the beginning of the next session, or if a complication occurs, instead of me introducing a complication, you can be like, weather now, and I'll be like, uh-oh, I guess I have to because you told me.
Okay.
It means is the rain today is probably not going to go away because I already introduced a weather complication, but next session, the rain might go away. And you can be like, oh, look, it's calm skies. Or you can be like, oh, look, lightning is falling from the sky. I mean, you tell me what the weather will be. Are you willing to put down the dice you need to try to
Because right now, it's raining ants and beetles over here.
It's beetles. That's amazing, Virgil. That's so good.
If I'm right, though, if I fail, it's a twist right away, right?
Yes.
Right.
Go for snow.
Yeah. Okay. Well, what do you guys think?
It's up to you.
Roll dice, man.
But we can. I mean,
believe in the heart of the cards. Scientist or something.
Or am I the only one that has it too?
I don't have it.
Okay, because I'd be willing to help you, but I think we're still gonna fail.
Yeah, I think we would fail because I have 4 dice in it, and even if I use my trait, that's 5.
And then that would help, and
then we have to succeed on all of them.
Yeah.
So.
I mean, if you have base, I could also reroll if you got any 6s. But.
Yeah, that's true.
You can do it. You can do it. Believe in the heart of the cards.
Yeah. And it would. Yeah. Okay, I'll use it. Let's go
great.
For it.
I'm in. I'm helping.
Okay. So I'm rolling 6 dice.
Oh boy.
Oh boy.
Indeed. Oh, and I got 3, so I'm spending fate.
Oh, snap.
5 successes.
Wow, that's a huge roll.
No, it's so good. All right, come on. 3 more dice and you can do it.
Wow, I can't believe...
No!
No!
No.
I can't believe we both rolled 66 and we both got 5 successes. Those were good rolls, but...
Oh. Man. Wow.
You can drop a persona if you want to mouse nature this. It's within your nature, so it won't tax.
Mouse nature.
And then this is just a card that's like in my back pocket kind of thing? Okay, I'll spend it. Or I thought you can't spend fate and persona on the same roll.
I don't know that that's true. It's certainly not true in Burning Wheel.
Okay. We'll say that it is.
Yeah, I mean, I'll check after the show.
I barely got it.
Oh, snap. All right, what next session, what would you like the weather to be?
I want it to be cheerful and happy for us all.
I will tell you what options you can pick from the weather list.
So. It's raining men. Hallelujah. It's raining men.
I don't think that's one of them.
I think that there's like where, like after we have this whole heart to heart and the sun, whatever through the rain, where Marigold and Bartholomeus are like, like on the top of a hill or something where they can see to the horizon and are discussing like how we can see the blue sky and with the winds the way they are.
I mean, I guess what you're saying is you look out towards the horizon, you turn to him and say, I can see clearly now, the rain is gone. Bum, 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 bum.
Maybe, depending on our options.
Your options are the following. Clear and warm, spring snow, spring rain, spring storm, unseasonably cold, unseasonably warm.
Let's go with the first one.
The one where the weather's good.
Clear and warm.
Yeah, and all, and it, like, yeah, so
was
maybe...
clear and warm one of the choices?
Yeah, clear and warm.
Yeah, that would, I'll choose.
Next then... session, it will be clear and warm. And, interesting piece of news, that will be the third weather-related twist, which means at the end of next session, the weather will advance into the summer season.
Right.
Mm.
And, when the living's easy.
Yeah, so we're up on the hill, and, like, it's still raining and stuff, but after that conversation, the Marigold and I are both, like, we both know that it's going to be, once we weather this, it's going to be great. And sure. And when they look past the horizon, maybe there's something coming. Mm-hmm. And we keep moving.
Perfect.
And despite being sick and injured, my spirits have been lifted.
Yeah.
So, down the road, the rain trails off into huge fat drops. And between those huge fat drops, you do hear the croaking of a frog. As you get closer, you notice an enormous frog has set up in the middle of the road and has dug out like a nesting burrow in it, destroying the road in the process. Turning it into, like, you know, like a reverse arch.
Oh my goodness.
Arturo just sighs and takes out his bow.
I immediately put my hand.
Look, don't! I think it's light aches in the road.
There are two overturned carts nearby that have spilled goods, and there are numerous, like, dead insects lying nearby as well, in a small pile.
Okay.
The frog doesn't seem to have noticed you yet, and is singing in frog language, which just sounds like ribbit, ribbit,
ribbit. It's singing?
Yeah, I mean, unless you want to make a check to understand and speak to it, you don't really understand what's going on, but it's singing the language of frogs. Ribbit, 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 ribbit.
I would like to try to do that.
Okay. It is a lore mouse 5 check.
Okay. And I am very cunning, but I'm using it against me because this is a bad idea.
Perfect. You're like, I don't need to play smart with this frog. It's an idiot.
You can help him.
Okay, you're gonna jump in and aid. What are you helping with?
I was
scientist or lore mouse.
Virgil has
frogwise.
Frogwise, but I don't know.
Do you want to be bound by the failure here?
I
don't.
I think that would be a bad idea, guys.
I'm like,
just then pick. If it's stuck out, it might be late eggs. That's why I'd be angry.
So I'll...
Oh, that's right. You can frogwise to give him a die without suffering from it. Yep. Oh. Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Well, that was it, maybe. Maybe.
Yeah, that was it. You're just like, stand back.
Yeah.
Recognize that you have to check yourself before you wreck yourself.
Yeah, so I'll like approach and I'll have my hands up and I'll be like, let us speak plainly, creature, and fail no matter what.
It just like turns away from you, lashes its tongue out to an insect, and starts chewing it right in front of you. And then it says like, ribbit, ribbit, caro, caro. And you're just like,
Yeah.
What? Slow down. Pasta? Mustard sauce? Something?
Yeah. So it's talking about food. All right.
Can I have insectrist. Can I try to get close enough to take a peek at these bugs and see if they're just normal looking bugs to me?
You can go ahead and take an insectrist. It's a 2.
Okay, so I have 2 dice in it. So I need to roll both of those perfectly, right?
Yeah. Are you going to get help from anybody?
Yeah, I'm just gonna like creep over and I'm like,
I'm just gonna try to get close and look at the bugs he's eaten. Make sure they look like they're okay.
Okay. I don't think I have anything to help you with. Unless, no, I can't use that because. Hunter?
I've got a hunter.
Survivalist?
Maybe. Let me see. Maybe I have something.
Roadwise?
Pathfinder?
Let's see here. What can aid? Skills is 224. And you want to aid on an insectrist. Lore Mouse is the only aid.
Oh, I have that.
Okay, so you're creeping over with me?
Yeah.
Like... You're both like
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Come on, baby. One success. Darn it.
So while you're all watching, you continue to creep over towards these insects. When there's like a slight rumbling noise that kind of drowns out the falling of the fat plops of rain. And it starts getting louder and louder, and things on the ground near you start shaking, and the water puddles start Jurassic Parking. And the bullfrog just leaps up into a tree nearby and looks down at you and is like, Caro, Caro. And as you watch to the west, there is a mud stream just like going. There's sticks caught in it. There's rocks coming towards you. Some river has gone out of control and is sending a spray of mud in your direction that's just going to wipe you out.
I want to make a boat.
I mean, you do. Yeah. You know what? If you grab like a leaf boat.
Yeah, I have boat crafter.
I'd like to help with harvest. Like help
with I'm survivalist.
Survivalist, carpenter, scientist.
I've got survivalist.
I like how you keep wanting to help with harvester. Harvester is used to gather grain, seeds, roots, and herbs, or making things that you would put in a jar.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, you put frogs in a jar with like a leaf.
No, not mice do not put frogs in a jar. Humans put frogs in a jar.
I'm gonna use calm for me, saying calm in the situation.
It's like stand tall, men.
Yeah.
So stand in the leaf. It will carry us.
Wait. So you're gonna die for me, and you're gonna get a die from Sam.
Yeah, true? And I'm gonna just look for higher ground.
Okay, you're not going to ride in the leaf boat then.
No, you're gonna ride in leaf boat. You don't have to help us, but you need to ride in the leaf
Marigold,
boat.
Like, grabs you as you start
don't take around. Risks. Boats flip upside down. Trees don't.
No. Yeah. It'd be a risk to get us separated. Come on, you need to come with us, Gerald.
I'm like shaking because I'm like cold and wet and terrified, and like look up at the like rushing floodwater. So I'm like,
the boat won't hold. It's ridiculous. Get on the tree. We can make one later.
I'll pick him up and carry him over.
I mean, if that's not something he wants to have happen, it's not going to happen.
Yeah, I'm not. I mean, that's definitely not going to help for the boat flipping over part.
all right.
I've used boats before and I've wrestled in them. The boat does not stay upright.
So there are two separate checks here. Team boat will need to make a boat crafting check. Team Gerald will need to make a survivalist check. Both of these are obstacle 3.
Okay.
All right, I'm on team boat.
Team boat, working together and staying calm. You wait in your leaf boat for the mud to come, and like a surfboard, you get caught up on the front of it, and then you just ride the back of the mud stream. You're being taken very far off the road, however. You're going deep into the wild here.
Bye, Gerald.
Gerald, you are left near the bullfrog, who's just looking at you with big eyes like, ribbit.
Yeah, I imagine I'm like sitting on a branch next to him, like So I don't have what was it, survivalist? I don't have that.
That's bad.
Oh, that's super bad.
You're gonna die.
I can't like pathfind a safe way.
Pathfind would be to like run ahead of it as fast as possible. Pathfind is used to mark paths between mouse towns and cities.
Okay.
Resources, yes. Do you have scout?
Yeah.
I would take scout at op 3.
Okay, so yeah, I just look around like as quick as I can for a safe branch. I imagine the bullfrog is probably already chosen.
Yeah.
Branch. And I will give myself, what do I get, 5 more die for
mouse nature? Yep, and this is actually going towards mouse nature, so you're okay. Attempting to escape.
Well, so you spent 2 persona already?
Yeah, he's blowing all the persona right now.
Well, this does seem like a good place.
Seem like a good time to not get caught up in a mudslide.
Yeah.
Did you say op 3?
Yep.
Okay, I'm rolling 7 dice. 3 successes.
Yeah, the bullfrog just stays up there. He's not going anywhere, but he sits there and talks to you. You don't really understand what he's saying.
And then
he's
like nod.
Gently singing a frog lullaby to you. You catch a couple words. He seems to be trying to console you.
What a nice frog.
Yeah, it seems like a nice guy.
After a few hours, the mud boat comes to an end as the river runs out of power. You're in the middle of nowhere. You're completely lost. And my GM...
There's no way we could have, like, tried to get it to run aground before we'd been on the boat for literally hours.
My GM turn is at an end. It is the player turn time. You are not at Elmas yet. One group is completely lost. The other group, namely just Gerald, has not dealt with the frog, has not completed the mission. But you are at the road, which is currently mud washed out.
Great.
You each just have one great check, except for Bartholomeus, who I believe has 2.
Oh, yeah. So wait, what do I mark for that? My
scout. So scout success.
Yeah, I've got 1 extra for cunning against me.
Who would like to play your turn first?
I can use a check to try to be uninjured, right?
Yes. So let's see here. I think it's pretty involved, and it usually goes better in town.
Is it better if Marigold heals us?
Yes, but that takes her check, I think. Let's see here.
Yeah.
Player turns, found mouse, blah, 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 blah. Checks, losing character. Recover. During the player turn, you may try to recover from 1 or more conditions. It involves a test and therefore eats up your check. And how do you recover from these? Oh, you know what? It's probably under the conditions section. Sorry for holding you up, audience. This is some high-end stuff we haven't had to do before. Yep, there's literally a chapter called recovery. Okay.
Do we want to do early break?
No.
Okay.
I think we're good here. Okay, you have to alleviate conditions in the following order: hungry, thirsty, angry, tired, injured, and then sick. So, you have to do your injured first. Recovering from injured is an ob 4 health test to overcome pain and discomfort. To treat an injury, a healer must make an ob 3 skill test. I'm sorry. No. Okay. Here's how it goes. You make an op 4 health test. If you fail, you keep your penalty until you have a healer come and try to heal you and it gets reset.
All right. Well, I need success on all 4 dice.
Look at that cat.
Can you guys see how my cat is sleeping? It's like an S shape. That is
big. Yep. It's a little strange.
The butt. There's the
look at that. That was adorable.
It's like head is just pushed against it. No big deal.
That sounds like my cat's.
Can I use
So here's the good news.
Here's
the good news. When you are recovering from a health test, you don't take the minuses from pre-existing conditions.
Okay, that's better.
You can take checks for something, but it doesn't reset. So you guys can uncheck all of your like used, unused right now for traits. Okay. It's reset.
But like, can I earn checks for next time during this one?
Nope.
Well, then I'm just rolling five dice.
That's a dangerous game right there. You got any persona?
Nope.
Tell, before you roll, how are you attempting to recover from your injury? I don't know that we ever describe specifically what it is. Just kind of general battle fatigue and bruising.
I think Arturo's just kind of just like miserable and like he like from like the sickness and the injury kind of like by doing the same things. He's just like trying to like build fires as like hot as he can every night and sleeps close and tries to make sure he like drinks soup and stuff. He probably knows some like herbs that are like
you put your herbs in your chicken soup broth.
Yeah, for like survivalisting.
Can I help with that?
Yes, you can help with his ob for health test. You will help with health.
Oh, I have to help with health?
Yes.
Okay. That's fine.
You are bound by the failure, just to...
I know.
Okay.
Just like we're bound.
Sick, injured... Marigold is like leaning over you and like patting your head with a cloth and like squeezing out and patting her own head.
Yeah.
Ouch.
Wow. Well. So close. So close. Got any fate or persona?
Well, I have plenty of fate, but it doesn't
you don't
matter.
Have enough. Oh no.
Well,
what do you mean? Couldn't he use his nature or whatever?
You need a persona to do that.
Oh.
Alternatively, after falling ill, the player may choose to have his character waive the attentions of a healer. In this case, the condition is removed and the player suffers a permanent injury.
Yes.
As described above.
That means you take a permanent minus one to any ability or skill.
Well, I don't want to do that.
Right.
You can just continue.
Instead, you now suffer pain and discomfort until you find a healer who gives an ob 3 skill test to heal you.
Well, that is a bummer. All right.
For sick, not injured, because you have to.
You have to alleviate injured first.
Oh, I thought it was sick first, then injured.
Nope. Injured first.
Injured first and then sick. Okay.
Yep.
Well, I would like to also try to be uninjured.
Okay.
And afterwards, I can try to heal you with a healer test.
Do you have a second check?
Well, we all get one for free.
Right.
And then I have one.
You're
more.
Using yours on yourself, though.
Right. I'm using my free one on myself, and then I have one more.
Did you use something against you?
Yes.
Okay. Excellent.
Determined against me when we were talking to that guy.
Yeah. What do your injuries look like?
I think she's got like her arm is in a sling. It's like maybe she hyperextended it, or it was. Like landed on it wrong, like a dislocated elbow or something.
That sounds really bad.
I've had a dislocated elbow. It's kind of sucky.
Yeah, that sounds really bad.
So I need a ob 4 health test, and I have no arthur whatsoever.
Oh, that's rough. You gotta.
No, I do have a persona.
Dice gods better be good for you.
I do have a persona.
You gonna try to just live your life right here with this roll?
I mean, I need a.
I can help.
On 4 dice.
I can help.
You're willing to help me?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what happens. Like, I'm already injured, so like, what's the consequence?
Probably something bad. You'll probably lose an item somehow. You know, like during the shuffle, we find out that. You lost your weapon during the mudslide, and you hadn't noticed until now.
Well, I'll still help.
It's brave, brave right there, willing to go in the wilds without a weapon.
What about Bartholomew? Are you gonna, Bartholomeus, are you gonna help out here? Are you just gonna let us be sick and injured alone?
Does it take a check for me to help?
No,
them?
No.
Oh, okay. Can I help them with survivalists?
You can only help health with health.
What does that mean?
Health is a stat.
Okay, so if I help them, then...
Yep, you would get a pass or fail towards health.
Oh, okay, well then I'll do that.
Yeah, all right, cool. Sounds like you've got two helping die. I'm assuming cat-related shenanigans right there.
It's cat-related shenanigans, sorry. I was trying to figure out what she was doing. She is in a box. No! No!
It's rough.
Damn it. I'm sorry, everybody.
How could you do this?
The good news is that I'm suddenly healthier.
Oh, you're going to take the injury?
Oh, no.
No, I mean, I have... that's,
oh, you failed enough that your health increases.
Right. I'm going to continue to be...
Your overall health, right.
But my overall health increases.
All right. Well, bad news for Bartholomeus and Arturo. Both of you lost your weapons when your leaf boat was going downstream. And you didn't notice until now. Like, you're helping Marigold. And then, like, each of you looks over at each other's sheath and notices, you know, it's gone.
Sure? Do I lose my bow and my knife?
Probably the bow, because that's what we see you using more.
Okay, sure.
Do you think that I lost my sword or my rope?
Sword.
Okay. Good try, though.
Yeah.
I don't see you using a rope as a weapon, but show me that as soon as you can.
Lasso.
Yeah. Who's next on the checklist? We have to do Gerald and Bartholomeus before we go around again.
Right. Well, we can go back to Gerald because he's singing.
Yeah. I mean, I guess it's time to try to follow this. I mean, it's not going to be hard to follow this flow, right? But I want to, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to try to look in this tree that we're on, if I can like find any hollow nooks or anything, and see if there is like a nest of sal bugs or some type of bug that I can get the attention of the frog with. Stir up a little nest or something.
To what end?
To make sure that the frog... is like happy where he is and doesn't want to move.
You want him to not move from the tree, or you want him to not move from the road?
From the tree. I want him to like be...
You want him to like live in the tree forever.
He's now a tree frog because there's so much good food in the tree.
Okay, that's the thing you can do. That's going to be difficulty 4. Insect check. To like convince the frog there's enough here for him to eat. Yes.
Okay. So, I don't think I can make it, but it's fine. So insect, I get 2 dice. 1 for frog.
Yep.
3 dice. 3d6.
Wait, where's the 1 for frog coming from?
Frog wise?
Oh, no, you can't fork that in. That's when you're telling other people how to treat frogs.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
And how else can I make my role better? That's it, huh?
I mean, if you don't have persona and fate.
I have fate, but that's for a re-rolling 6.
Yeah, it's for re-rolling 6s.
All right, let's see how many 6s we can get.
None. Okay. Yeah.
So I, like, find 1 sal bug and, like, hold it up.
What happens is the frog lashes out with his tongue. And for a moment, it looks like it's going to hit you and you cower. And it grabs the last of your rations and your water skin. And just takes your food and your drink. And you are now hungry and thirsty. You're alone in the woods. That. The frog has just taken all of your stuff and is eating and drinking it right in front of you.
Wow.
So that's -1 to any conflict.
Yes.
So does that mean on my next thing when I try to go chase them. That's not a conflict, right? To find someone?
Conflict is like when we sit down to fight.
Okay, yeah, cool. Okay.
I want to point out the party's still not together. Bartholemeus, you've got some very tired, very... Well, I guess they're not tired. They're just injured and sick comrades without weapons.
Yeah.
Okay. Still need staff, it's fine. It's
you
fine.
Have a staff and a dagger between three of you.
I mean, I kicked the ass of that ferret with that staff, so it's fine.
And your tender paw is just disappeared, gone.
We know how to find you. We'll get on that.
So can I like paddle back then?
Yeah, yeah. It would probably be like survivalist or pathfinder. It would almost certainly be pathfinder, I think.
Yeah. Okay. I have to follow three the path back.
Yep.
And can I use cunning for me?
Yes. Yeah.
Can I help?
It's gonna be yeah. If he accepts your help, what are you helping with?
I would like to help with Pathfinder.
Yeah. Perfection. This is op 2.
Okay, so that makes
sense. You were basically blown east, so it's not that hard to just travel back west.
Right.
The mud flow is very, very obvious. You know, it's like knocked everything out of its path. Yeah. Yeah, you lead your party in your mud boat. As you're getting there, the like clear, warm day is starting to dry the mud to the point that like right as you get to Gerald, you just hit like solid earth, and you're like, oh, you're done. You're done here.
And I like help the two injured people out, and I call out to Gerald, and I say, "Are you all right?"
Right. Oh my goodness, he found me! I'm coming down.
Ribbit.
Okay. I just like pet the frog and run, skitter down the tree.
And then I can't spend a check to try to heal somebody else, can I?
Actually, you can't do two checks in a row, which means it's Marigold's turn.
Right, okay.
Right.
So.
Heal someone.
You can make an op 3 health test to heal Arturo, and that will remove his injury.
Can't I make a healer test?
Yes, a healer test.
Okay.
Op 3.
Op 3 healer test.
What helps healer?
The bad news is that all of your penalties are still in place, so you're taking a minus 2 to the roll.
Yeah.
What does help healer? Let's find out very shortly.
I have a healer of 5, so even at a minus 2, I'm at 3 dice.
That's monstrous healer.
I know.
Scientist helps healer.
Oh, I don't have it. I have no scientists.
I'm not a sciencey type mouse.
I'm a fairly sciencey mouse, but I guess it doesn't. I guess it doesn't really matter, does it?
Well, if you use a trait for you to help you.
I could, can I use determined for me here?
Yeah, can you montage how your determination is like, no, I'm not losing you.
America.
I thought it was more just like me gritting my teeth as I help him while I have my arm in a sling. And I'm like... Right.
You're taking a chance, you're risking it all.
Well, I'm injured myself doing this, so.
Yep.
Okay.
Hey,
because I always put others. No!
Wow. Zero.
Like, I always put others' injuries before myself, but no, I just got nothing. Nothing.
While you're working on your kit.
Wow.
You've got
I put the formula in wrong, but secondly, I still rolled terribly.
While you're working on it all, the bullfrog hops down, and in your excitement, you like drop the kit, and it lands on it and smashes all your sterile bandages are covered in mud. Everything that's in a glass container is shattered, and the bullfrog's just in front of you, like rabbit, 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 rabbit.
Does anybody speak frog?
ribbit.
I do not.
I'll just speak a little bit. Make it hard to understand bullfrog because I'm used to riding tree frogs. It's got a very thick accent.
Well, we still need to get moved off of the road here if we can. Bartholomew?
I mean, I could try to talk to it again, but...
So I can't do another action, right?
No.
Right.
It's just Bartholomew now.
Can he give his check to somebody else?
Yes, he can.
Yeah, I can.
I don't know if somebody else would be better suited for a check right now, but...
I have two in Lore Mouse.
Yeah, I have two in Lore Mouse, so I can help you.
The other problem is with me failing to cure that injury, the injured status goes away and you take a permanent penalty to your health because a healer made the attempt and failed.
Yeah, so you got injured.
So you get to pick, buddy. You get a permanent minus one to a skill or stat.
Pick something stupid.
Charisma.
Yeah.
You can't pick resources or circles. Oh, it's of my choosing. Oh, well, let me just look over your sheet and see what you've become worse at, Arturo.
That makes more sense.
Thank you. You also will lose any check marks for pass or fail that you'd made towards progressing that thing.
No.
Is it health?
Oh my god, if it was health, that would totally wreck him so badly.
Yeah, I am one fail away from upping my health.
I'm gonna go with survivalist.
No.
Your survivalist drops a one. Like, this experience has taught you how little you know about surviving in the wild. You're just like, I don't know. How do I survive out here? Oh. Yeah, it's rough.
Man, we've had rotten luck tonight.
We really have.
Yeah, yeah. It's been bad. It's been super bad. Barty?
Can I just like tie my rope around the frog and lead him away like he's a pet?
I mean, like, that's like conflict. That's something you can do, but it's going to be a battle against the frog. It's not okay. Like sword battle, but it's going to be like the frog's like, I'm not going anywhere.
Ribbit. So he really wants to chill.
The frog is larger than any of the mice. It's
yes,
like,
it's much bigger than you. So, it could eat you.
So he wants to chill here for sure though?
Oh yeah. Okay. All attempts to communicate with the frog have failed.
Yeah. Okay, so I'll ask Gerald, what do frogs really like? What can we...
You know what? I think I threw a twist at you. Does that mean you pass? I think if you twist, you pass, but something bad happens. It's condition if you fail, or you can twist it. I'll tell you what, yeah, the frog does get hopping now. It sees all of you here, and it's just like...
Ripped. Yeah.
And the frog ruined it, right?
I'm just like,
go on then, frog. Somewhere else then. I don't think it's working.
And then maybe he starts hopping off.
Whoop-up. Whoop-up. And no one's really sure if Gerald's the one that convinced
her. It's like finding Dory when she says that she can talk to whales, right? Yeah. And like, can you talk to whales though? The whale did seem to do what it said.
Sorry.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So maybe I'll spend my check to try to whip up a sword from the wilderness.
You can't make a sword. You can make like a wooden stick.
A staff, then?
You can't make a stick either. You have to, like, you know, get it from a tree.
You could make a staff for sure.
Can I use my carpenter to make a wooden sword then?
Like a practice sword?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, this would probably be like difficulty 3.
Could he use this carpenter skill to make me a bow?
Yeah, but that would be 4 because that requires, you know, rather than just being a straight thing, it's got to be like specifically curved and all that.
It's really hard to get wood too that you can bend that that well, and then
it just might be more useful to have a bow than a wooden sword.
Yeah, Carpenter 3 for like a low quality wooden sword.
I only have Carpenter 2 anyway, though.
Oh, yeah, okay, never mind.
So,
go for it. Don't let your. I mean, you're just.
I'm gonna.
Look how bad you've been rolling. You're owed good rolls, right? Look at the last roll. It was terrible. We are owed lots of sixes. Yeah, yeah, 2, 3, and, 1, 1.
And roll in it. In the fiction, I think that's what he would be doing.
Kids at home, way. That's not how math works.
He's gonna.
I'm just trying to convince bad things to happen.
He's gonna stay calm and collected, though. And he's going to use that for himself.
Okay. You're really banking on rolling 3 successes then.
Yes.
Statistically, ready for some math? That's 1/2 to the 3rd power.
That's not very good.
That's the chance of that happening.
Yeah.
That's 0.125 or 1/8.
But he's going to give it his all instead of like, you know, like he's going to be like, I need to be able to protect my fellow mice. So I have to do both. My best job forging and making this.
Let's get down to business to defeat.
Learn how to roll and roll 20.
Yeah.
You know, you can just press up and it'll go to the last roll.
Oh boy.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
Yeah, best thing.
Yeah, you're desperately trying to get this sword working and you just end up so frustrated. Why isn't it coming? Why is this patrol falling apart? Why can't anyone work with me? You know, the voices in your head are at complete conflict with your usual calm demeanor and your leadership skills. Your self-degradation is slowly crumbling the facade, however facade. You pronounce that
facade?
Word. Facade. Of your like, normal, you know... calmness, and you're just super frustrated, and eventually you snap the sword in half when it just won't work right.
Yeah.
I think we're out of checks.
We are out of checks.
So
do we have any balances?
I'll tell you what's going to happen. We are going to head into Elmas. And then we will check beliefs, instincts, and goals, and perhaps jump into another session. So let's go ahead and take that break.
Great.
And hope that the dice will warm up during that time.
Yes.
See if we can get them out of the freezer real quick. Remember, follow, like, subscribe. Maybe consider checking out patreon.com/apgamingreal. I don't know if that's a thing you want to do. Maybe it is. I don't know. We'll be back in about 7 minutes.